Hey, what's up guys, it's Tekosaur, and as we previously did, some tuning on the Ally X, starting with tightening the memory timings, and later on, lifting up the TDP limit from 30W to 50W. Today, I'm bringing you this video targeted at finding the best GPU clock you can set manually for squeezing even more performance out of it. We previously covered this on the Ally OG and the Lenovo Legion Go, so if you are aware of that video, you will know the process exactly. But in this video, I want to pinpoint the exact GPU clock that delivers the best possible results. So buckle up and get ready for even more free performance improvement set in just a few seconds. Starting off by installing the Universal X86 Tuning Utility, which is a free tool used to control some Ryzen-based chips. Once you have it installed, go to Adaptive Mode Settings, where you can set the TDP and maximum temperature. I've set the TDP to 50W and maximum temp to 105 degrees Celsius. Keep in mind that for the TDP, I've made the same changes in BIOS by using the smokeless tool as in the previous video. Otherwise, the TDP might revert to 30W after a few minutes if you set it just in Windows. To avoid that, you need to set it in both BIOS and OS. In the Turbo Boost Override iGPU settings, we can set the minimum and maximum GPU clocks, and the minimum CPU clock as well. I've set the minimum CPU clock to 4000 MHz, although I've noticed that it doesn't impact much as the CPU clock still goes below 4000 MHz, even with this set this way. Now as for the GPU clock, it seems better controlled. We have a range from 200 up to 3300 MHz. When doing this manual GPU clock tweak, it's recommended to set both minimum and maximum clocks in the same range to avoid fluctuations and ensure steady performance. Now based on experiment I did off camera, I'll show you benchmarks from 1500 to 3000 MHz, and we'll see why going too high isn't better, even in case when we have extra power budget at our disposal like 50W. So once you set them, ensure this toggle is activated. You can save your custom profile for future use and activate the auto switch app profile feature by creating different profiles for each game or scenario. Also remember to toggle on the auto switch option. To make your changes in effect, you can start adaptive mode manually by pressing here. But even if you stop it, GPU clock may remain set at what you manually set it to. So it will be better to restart the whole system for it to return to automatic control. Now before jumping to benchmarks, I need to mention some info about my testing setup. I have the memory timing tightened to exact values from previous video, and they are pinned in the comment of this video. And TDP set to 50W. As shown previously, I have the latest Ally X BIOS and the latest GPU driver as well, with features such as AFMF, anti-lag and others disabled. All the drivers are installed from Armory Crate, and still in Armory Crate, I'm using a custom power profile and all limits are set at 30W with full fan speed. And also, I have CPU boost on. For GPU VRAM, it's set to the default 8G. Windows 11 version I'm using is 24H2. Finally, all games benchmarks are on 900p resolution at low settings. Now starting with Cyberpunk 2077, I've tested from the default, which means automatic without any tinkering at all the way to manually 3000 MHz of GPU clock. Now the reason we also have 2525, 2550 and 2575 MHz is because I found the best performance mostly at that range. So from 2500 to 2600 MHz seems the optimal choice, as performance start to creep off at like below 2300 MHz, but still manages to be better than the default. At 2500 MHz for instance, we averaged at 56.8 FPS versus 55 on default. But going beyond 2700 MHz or higher actually reduced performance significantly, since the GPU needs more power at that point, which start to take away from the CPU and memory. So our worst result was 2900 MHz, with only 16 FPS on average. Next, when I started to understand the range to test from, I did a 3D Mark Steel Nomad light test from 2500 to 2700 MHz. And here 2500 MHz scored 2998, while the highest we got is when we have 2625 MHz, which got 3036. beyond 2650 MHz, performance started to drop. But still, that wasn't enough, as we need more benchmarks to gather accurate insights. So for the next game's benchmarks, I tested from 2500 to 2600 MHz, since this range seems the best. I also included the default as a baseline. The top settings in the chart for Wukong are 2575 and 2550 MHz. It's not always necessary that 2600 MHz or higher is better, as we saw in the Steel Nomad light test. Game performance can vary due to multiple factors, but 2575 seems a good spot based on the results so far, getting around 2.5 FPS in this game. In Horizon Zero Dawn, 2525 and 2550 top the chart, just slightly ahead of the default. However, in Counter-Strike 2, we saw a significant difference, with a boost of up to 17 FPS in case of 2575 MHz, which performed the best, with 2550 close behind and 2525 a bit further down. So far, we have seen that 2550 and 2575 are mostly leading the charts, showing that GPU manual clock tweaking has indeed an effect to some extent. Instead, in Shadow of the Tomb Raider, we have a minimal difference overall, but 2600 MHz scored the most, getting 98.4 average FPS. But like in the Callisto Protocol, 2600 MHz actually performed the worst, with 54.6 FPS, which is lower than default by around 3. The best here was 2500 MHz, suggesting a lower GPU clock can be more favorable in this title. Finally, in Red Dead Redemption 2, again, 2575 MHz got the highest FPS at 67, just 1 FPS more than the default, with 2550 MHz close behind. So based on all the data we've got, 2575 MHz of GPU clock seems to be the sweet balance overall. It got good uplift in Steel Nomad Lite benchmark, averaged high scores in most games, with titles such as Counter-Strike 2 getting over a 17 FPS boost on average. So guys, that's it for this video. From all the tests we have done, looks like 2575 MHz is the best choice for GPU clock, with CPU boost enabled, tight memory timing set, and the 50W TDP tweak. That's how I'll set my Ally X from this point on while gaming. Finally, now that we have done those tweaks, I have a surprise video coming up, so be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you found this video useful, please give it a like to help with the YouTube algorithm. Also, if you have any issue with setting your Ally X this way, leave a comment below and I'll get back to you, or reach out at the TechoSword Discord server. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Peace out.